This is the Feminist Criticism on the Ring 1998 version, a film that adapted from the novel into major motion pictures by Koji Suzuki. The story contains gender roles as one of the issues. We are your hosts,
Thirisara Bunchoy
and Napatson Dresap, the liberal arts senior students from Mae Fah Luang University.
Let's start with the summary. Asakawa Reiko is a reporter who lost her niece, Tomoko. She investigated the rumor about one videotape that people who watch it will die in a week. Additionally, she also assumed that this was related to the death of Tomoko and her friends, because before they died, all of them had watched the same videotape and received the call after finishing watching the video. The mysteries of death are that all of them died at the same time, and their faces filled with fear. Reiko found the photo of Tomoko and her friends that they took in front of the one cabin, and their faces in the photo were blurred. So she decided to go to the place in Izu in the photo to investigate the mysterious death. And then she found the videotape at the reception room. After that, she went to watch the tape in the cabin named B4, the same as Tomoko. In the videotape, there were sequences of a short unconnected video. After finishing watching, there was a call instantly, and Reiko received the call and realized the curse of the well-known tale about video. So she thought she would die in 7 days. The next day, she decided to ask for help from Ryuji Takayama, her former husband. However, he did not believe what she said, so she asked Ryuji to take a picture of her as proof. For people who received the curse, their faces would be blurred. When Ryuji saw that her face was blurred in the photo, he believed that she was cursed. Ryuji decided to watch the videotape, even though Reiko disagreed with his decision. Ryuji asked Reiko to copy the tape for him, so he could examine the video. Both of them went to watch the video and discovered the message that contained a dialect in Izu Oshima Island in the tape.
That night, Reiko's son watched the video while she was sleeping. Therefore, Reiko and Ryuji went to Izu Oshima Island. They found out about Shizuko Yamamura's life, who lost her own daughter named Sadako. Moreover, Reiko and Ryuji also discovered that Sadako was killed by her father and was thrown into the well. However, she's still alive after she was thrown to the well 7 days. As a result of having a powerful psychic, Sadako's spirit was vengeful, leading to creating the cursed videotape. Thus, Reiko and Ryuji made a decision to go to the cabin where everything started, because the well was under the cabin name B4. Both of them tried to bail out the water in the well in order to find the dead body of Sadako. Finally, they found the body, and they assumed that the curse was over because Reiko was still alive after a week. However, when it was the last day of Ryuji, things turned out in contrast. Sadako crawled out of the well and walked straight into the television position. She came out of television screen and killed Ryuji. Reiko tried to find what went wrong, and suddenly Ryuji's spirit told the clue to her via television screen by pointing to the brown bag. Thus, Reiko found the original videotape in it, which made her discover that it was because she copied the videotape to Ryuji. It was like the curse was sent to another. Bo, what do you think is the main issue in the story?
I think the main issue in the story is gender roles. As we can see in the movie, after Reiko knew that she was cursed, she came to Ryuji to ask for his help. It shows that she cannot decide what to do by herself, so she has to ask Ryuji, who was her ex-husband, to lead the decision. It also can relate to the Japanese culture that men are the leader and have more power than women. Therefore, men have to be the one who lead the action, and women are the followers, as similar as the role of Reiko and Ryuji in the movie.
I totally agree with you, because I saw the relationship between Reiko and Ryuji during the scene after they arrived at Izu Oshima Island. When they were eating dinner, the action of Ryuji when he told Reiko to stop the rumpus showed the absolute manner of himself as a leader of a family. Additionally, it could also be seen in the scene that he slapped Reiko to make her have consciousness when she was discouraged because it was almost her time to die. This action, even though it was his goodwill to Reiko, it was too violent.
Right? As it could be seen that gender role is one of the issues in the story. The feminist criticism would be used in order to discover the issue. But before we begin, let me introduce this literary theory first.
According to Nabokov's 2020, feminist literary criticism is the literary theory that look into the perspective of feminism, feminist politics, or feminist theory. The basic methods of this theory are 1. Identifying with female characters, which will look at what role those female characters are defined. Feminist literary criticisms include that in literature, women seem to be the object from men's point of view historically. 2. Re-evaluate literature and the world in which literature is read. The critics could have a questions to the society if they appreciate male works or others, for they value men over women.
As we look in the feminist point of view, from you asked about the main issue in the story. Which state do you think it was clearly separate male and female role to happen gender role as the main issue?
I see the feminine trait from Reiko as an obedient, sensitive, and emotional. We could see that she followed the lead of Ryuji to solve the problems or to find a way to break the curse. And when she found out that her son had watched the cursed videotape, she became very stressful and cried because she was afraid and asked Ryuji to stay with her when she died.
For me, I see the masculine trait from Ryuji as leadership, ambition, and courage. In the movie, it shows that Ryuji is the leader of breaking the curse, and he tried to do everything to break the curse. In addition, he did not hesitate to go down in the well to bail out the water to find the worthy for breaking the curse. So this could show that he is brave. Moreover, in other male characters, there is the scene where Shizuko show her psychic power, but men who were the audience in that scene did not believe that Shizuko had the power. And they thought that Shizuko cheated to show her power. I think it shows that men do not believe in the ability of women because they are arrogant in their power and they don't want women to have more power than them.
So, Bo, when we talk about women as a subject, another one to concern about is, have you ever wondered why every horror story always contains a ghost woman?
In my opinion, women are portrayed as victims from patriarchal society, as in the novel or the movie. Most of male characters always hurt or kill women as women are inferior. Therefore, as women are the victim in male perspective, most ghosts are portrayed to be women. And for the writer, want to show that women have anger and wrath and they want revenge on men, but they cannot do in the real life. That's why they can only portray their actions in the novel and the movie. Additionally, women are portrayed as villains in order to make men look better. It is also because of patriarchal society. In this society, men have to be portrayed as the better person than women. So men can still oppress women and hurt women. How about you, Sai?
100% for your point that women are portrayed as villains in order to make men look better. In my point of view, women are always the subject of the society of men for a long period of time. Even though men have the same human emotions as women, women's emotions tend to portray to be more intense than men, as we see in many horror movies that women come with feelings of wrath, as you have mentioned.
Apart from this, do you think the work itself reveals patriarchy society?
I definitely think that the work reveals about the patriarchy society in Japan. We could see the power relationships between Ryuji and Reiko clearly through the roles and the traits that we have discussed. Not only that, it also could be seen by the duties of women when Reiko said to Ryuji that they did not know if the curse would be broken if they found a dead body. Ryuji said to her if she gave up, who's gonna pick up her son again? Which shows the duties of women to look after the children, even though Ryuji also played a father role.
Right? I have found a journal from Fila talking about the patriarchy in Japan, that it is one of the primary countries as the example of patriarchal society. Japan's patriarchal culture is affected by Buddhist and Confucian. It created a mindset about the roles between men and women. Especially, Japan's rapid modernization, which forced the mindset or thought of the women to be the housewives and men as the breadwinner.
Thanks to Koji Suzuki, the author of The Ring, for portraying the gender issue in the story that could be seen in Japanese culture. Thank you for listening. We hope this might be helpful for you. It's Sai and Bo, the analysis podcast of the film Ring 1998 version.